We begin with a growing rift within the UNITEAM coalition. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. going on the offensive against his predecessor Rodrigo Duterte's verbal attacks. The comments of the erstwhile firebrand leader included an allegation President Marcos is a drug addict.
Si Bongbong Marcos bangag noon, ngayong presidente na bangag natin ang presidente. May drug addict tayo na presidente. Nung ako'y mayor, pinakitaan ako ng evidence ng PDEA. Doon sa listahan, nandoon yung pangalan mo. Ayaw kong sabihin yan kasi magkaibigan tayo. Kung hindi magkaibigan, magkakilala. Pumapasok kayo ng alanganin. Mr. President, baka susunod ka sa dinaanan ng tatay mo. Diyan ako takot. Ayaw ko mangyari sa iyo yan.
But Marcos, in an ambush interview, says Duterte's comments may have been prompted by his alleged use of an opioid painkiller. Duterte admitted in 2016 that he took fentanyl following a spinal injury from motorcycle accidents. As president, Duterte questioned the qualifications of one presidential contender whom he claimed is an illegal drug user. He did not directly name Marcos at that time.
PRRD has been taking the drug for a very long time now. When was the last time he told us that he was taking fentanyl? 5-6 years ago? Something like that. After 5-6 years, it has to affect yung kaya palagay ko, kaya nagkakaganyan. I hope his doctors take better care of him than this.
The Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency immediately denying Duterte's claims in a press briefing this morning. Here's a part of the agency's statement.
President Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr. was never in our watch list. The Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency categorically states that President Ferdinand Romualdez Marcos Jr. is not in its watch list. Contrary to the statement of former President Rodrigo Duterte, claiming that, and we quote, when he was the mayor of Davao, he was shown evidence by PDEA that in the list, the name of the president was there. End of quote. Former President Duterte was mayor of Davao from 1988 to 1998, from 2001 to 2010, then 2013 to 2016. PDEA, on the other hand, was activated on July 30, of 2002. When the agency was activated, it established its National Drug Information System, or NDIS, which is still in existence today. The NDIS is the intelligence database of all drug personalities, gathering inputs from counterparts from both law enforcement and intelligence agencies.
Pursuant to its mandate under Republic Act 9165 and the Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act of 2002, PDEA regularly conducts intelligence workshops in collaboration with other law enforcement agencies to update the NDIS. From its inception in 2002
and up to the present, President Ferdinand Romualdez Marcos was never in our NDIS. It is worthwhile to note that when the former president took over in 2016, his administration came out with a list which was then initially called the Narco List, sometimes referred to as the Duterte or PRRD list. And upon continuing validation and revalidation, it became the Interagency Drug Information Database, or IDID, IDID. The name of President Marcos is also not in the said list. Based on all the foregoing facts, the PDEA asserts that President Marcos Jr. is not and was never in its watch list.
The son of former President Duterte now calling on President Marcos to resign. Davao City Mayor Sebastian Duterte made that remark during a leaders' forum in Davao City opposing charter change. The mayor also accused Marcos of being lazy and lacking compassion.
All of these things that he is causing is oppressing the people. Maumagod na. Kaya giyuna niya, ilang politika. Ilang self-preservation sa ilang politika. Wa nila giyuna ang trabaho. So karon, imbes of opening up new opportunities, especially for those sa lower classes, kaya para mo improve ang kinabuhi sa mga Pilipino. Mr. President, kung wala kay gugma, kung wala kay aspirations sa imuhang nasod, resign.
House party leaders pushed back by filing a resolution expressing their support for Marcos. Deputy Speaker David Suarez says the resolution is meant to show the House's firm commitment to the Marcos administration. He called Duterte's statements disrespectful and baseless.
I think it's totally uncalled for. In the past 2 years, we have seen the performance of President Bongbong Marcos. We have seen how he steered reforms in the agriculture sector, in the infrastructure sector, in our economy, in the delivery of social services. And we have seen his commitment to the Filipino people.